good morning and welcome to our service of Matins from St. Harold's Church here in Albury-on-the-Hill, Gloucestershire. You are very welcome for wherever you are joining us, whether it's the benefice or beyond. And my thanks go to Ed Harvey and Susie Jones, who will be reading for us this morning. I will be preaching in this beautiful 13th century church during the service. Let us pray. Father God, thank you for this opportunity to worship you in this beautiful place. In Jesus' name, amen. When the wicked man turneth away from his wickedness that he hath committed, and doeth that which is lawful and right, he shall save his soul alive. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart, O God, thou wilt not despise. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Dearly beloved brethren, the scripture moveth us in sundry places to acknowledge and confess our manifold sins and wickedness, and that we should not dissemble nor cloak them before the face of Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, but confess them with a humble, lowly, penitent, and obedient heart, to the end that we may obtain forgiveness of the same by his infinite goodness and mercy. And although we ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before God, yet ought we most chiefly so to do when we assemble and meet together to render thanks for the great benefits that we have received at his hands, to set forth his most worthy praise, to hear his most holy word, and to ask those things which are requisite and necessary as well for the body as the soul. Wherefore I pray and beseech you, as many as are here present, to accompany me with a pure heart and a humble voice unto the throne of the heavenly grace, saying after me, Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And there is no health in us. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us, miserable offenders. Spare thou them, O God, which confess their faults. Restore thou them that are penitent, according to thy promises declared unto mankind, in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen. Grant, we beseech thee, merciful Lord, to thy faithful people pardon and peace, that they may be cleansed from all their sins and serve thee with a quiet mind through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
O Lord, open thou our lips,
and our mouth shall show forth thy praise.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
The reading is taken from the second book of Corinthians, at chapter 13, beginning at verse 11. Finally, brethren, farewell. Be perfect, be of good comfort, be of one mind, live in peace, and the God of love and peace shall be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the saints salute you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Ghost be with you all. Amen. This is the end of the reading.
O Lord, our Governor, how excellent is thy name in all the world, thou that hast set thy glory above the heavens. Out of the mouth of very babes and sucklings hast thou ordained strength, because of thine enemies, that thou mightest still the enemy and the avenger. For I will consider thy heavens, even the works of thy fingers, the moon and the stars, which thou hast ordained. What is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? Thou madest him lower than the angels, to crown him with glory and worship. Thou makest him to have dominion of the works of thy hands, and thou hast put all things in subjection under his feet, all sheep and oxen, yea, and the beasts of the field, the fowls of the air, and the fishes of the sea, and whatsoever walketh through the paths of the seas. O Lord, our Governor, how excellent is thy name in all the world. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The second reading is taken from Matthew chapter 28, beginning at verse 16. Then the 11 disciples went away into Galilee, into a mountain where Jesus had appointed them. And when they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, All power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen. Here endeth the second lesson.
Before his presence.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with thy spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
O Lord, show thy mercy upon us,
and grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the Queen,
and mercifully hear us when we call upon thee.
Endue thy ministers with righteousness,
and make thy chosen people joyful.
O Lord, save thy people,
and bless thine inheritance.
Give peace in our time, O Lord,
because there is none other that fighteth for us but only thou, O God.
God, make clean our hearts within us,
and take not thy Holy Spirit from us.
Almighty and everlasting God, who hast given unto us thy servants grace by the confession of a true faith, to acknowledge the glory of the eternal Trinity, and in the power of the divine majesty, to worship the unity, we beseech thee that thou wouldst keep us steadfast in this faith, and evermore defend us from all adversities, who livest and reignest one God, world without end. Amen.
O God, who art the author of peace and lover of concord, in knowledge of whom standeth our eternal life, whose service is perfect freedom, defend us, thy humble servants, in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in thy defence, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
O Lord, our heavenly Father, almighty and everlasting God, who hast safely brought us to the beginning of this day, defend us in the same with thy mighty power, and grant that this day we fall into no sin, neither run into any kind of danger, but that all our doings may be ordered by thy governance, to do always that is righteous in thy sight, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We come boldly to the throne of grace, praying to the Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, for mercy and grace. Father of heaven, whose love profound a ransom for our souls has found, we pray for the world, created by your love, for its nations and governments. For our Prime Minister and Her Majesty's government, and for our Queen and the royal family. We pray for the United States of America at this time of unrest and violence. Extend to them your peace, your pardoning love and grace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty Son, incarnate Word, our prophet, our priest, our redeemer, and our Lord, we pray for the Church created for your glory, for its ministry to reflect those works of yours. We pray today for the Evangelical Lutheran Church of Iceland and the Spanish Reformed Episcopal Church, and for our own five overseas partner dioceses, especially the Diocese of Karnataka Central and the Bishop Prasanna. We pray for Bishop Rachel and Bishop Robert, our own Diocese of Gloucester, and all the churches and people in our benefice, and for our schools in Acton Turville, Hawkesbury, and Laterton. Extend to us your salvation, growth, and grace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Eternal Spirit, by whose breath the soul is raised from sin and death, we pray for families and individuals created in your image, for the lonely, the bereaved, the sick, and the dying. We continue to pray for the NHS. And we pray for ourselves. And we offer up to you now, in stillness and peace, anyone known to us who needs our own prayers. Breathe on them the breath of life and bring them to your mercy and grace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Thrice holy, Father, Spirit, Son, mysterious Godhead, three in one. We pray for anyone known to us who has recently died. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. And may the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Bring us all to bow before your throne in heaven, to receive life and pardon, mercy and grace, for all eternity, now and forever. Amen. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May I speak, and may we all hear, in the name of the living God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our world is full of mysteries, and where there is a mystery, someone will try and solve it. Today we celebrate the mystery that God is Trinity. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, one God. And St. Columban, the 6th century Irish monk, suggested a way to consider this mystery. He said, "Those who want to understand the unfathomable depths of God must first consider the world of nature. Knowledge of the Trinity is rightly compared to the depths of the sea. The Godhead of the Trinity is to be found beyond the grasp of human understanding." And so the sea has always been the last great mystery. And when God answered Job, he said, "Have you entered into the springs of the sea or walked in the recesses of the deep?" I remember the amazing explorer and filmmaker Jacques Cousteau and his incredible documentaries in the 1970s that were groundbreaking and magical. It is good to compare the magnitude, the beauty, the silence and the vastness of the oceans with the Trinity, our God. I can imagine the seas flowing and ebbing. I can imagine three flowing from one and one flowing from three. Jacques Cousteau said, "The glory of nature provides evidence that God exists." Last Sunday, we celebrated Pentecost, and one moving, very powerful, grace-filled service was from Thy Kingdom Come, a movement that invites Christians from around the world to pray, "Come, Holy Spirit," for more people to know and have faith in Jesus Christ between Ascension and Pentecost. Pope Francis took part and movingly called on all Christians to seek a fresh outpouring of the Holy Spirit in order that they might be bearers of Christ's love, light, and hope. He said, "How much pain is all around us, how much emptiness, how much inconceivable grief." He said, "Let us then become messengers of the comfort bestowed by the Spirit, and let us ask the Spirit for the gift of unity. For only if we live as brothers and sisters can we spread the spirit of fraternity. This fraternity which we seek comes to us in the form of the Trinity, which underlies our complete faith. Father, the Creator, Son, the Redeemer, and Holy Spirit, the Comforter, one God, the Trinity gives us the awareness and the conviction of the presence of God within us and strengthens us to face all our problems in life with courage and hope." One Anglican churchman, William Whiting, in 1860, expressed this courage in God when he wrote the hymn, "Eternal Father, Strong to Save." He was 35 years old when he nearly died whilst travelling in a ship in a violent storm. And it is the last verse, which also was my own school hymn, which is such an anchor to our faith in life, especially during the tumults, these current times. "O Trinity of love and power, our brethren shield in danger's hour, from rock and tempest, fire and foe, protect them wheresoe'er they go. Thus evermore shall rise to thee glad hymns of praise from land and sea." Many seek to understand the Trinity with their heads, when searching for understanding with their hearts will make all the difference. St. Augustine wrote, "You see the Trinity if you see love." Love compels us to go on. And in our love for the Trinity, none is before or after another. None is greater or less than another. God invites us to live more deeply, just as we would dive into the oceans, to be in the awareness of the presence of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit within us. And God seeks the deepest communion with us. We are created in love and are called by name to be a loving community of persons. When we fail to love, each other and fail to forgive in community, we are not one, but divided. And as we try to walk in Jesus' steps in here, in this benefice and beyond, we might do well to pray these words. Be thou my wisdom, and thou my true word. I ever thee and thou with me, Lord, heart of my own heart, whatever befall. Still be my vision, O ruler of all. Amen. Let us pray. Holy God, faithful and unchanging, enlarge our minds with the knowledge of your truth and draw us more deeply into the love of your mystery, that we may truly worship you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time, with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and hast promised that when two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants, as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all, evermore. Amen.